Thanks for staying with us. Here's a recap of some of the big races and results this election night.
I want to show you what's going on behind me. So I am on I-10 coming into the city where it splits into US 90. Look at this. A car just literally minutes ago overturned. But more importantly, we just want to make sure that this person is okay. I mean, as you're looking at your screen, this is unfolding live right before you.
A suspect on the run after a Jefferson Parish deputy has been shot. Details just coming in. This is a developing story, but here's what we know. For the first time, this is a live look at the scene in Jefferson Parish. New at 10, a Slidell man under arrest in Florida, accused of shooting a van with kids inside.
WDSU taking you behind the scenes at the parish landfill, where a station report cites several issues.
It's not like they would just do that on their own, right? I mean, there must have been some kind of directive to allow that liquid industrial waste to be collected.
If that directive was made, we don't know.
Okay, Juliana, you can go.
I was ready to answer that call and admittedly was a little nervous. And that was it. Now all I had to do was sit back and relax. Well, Scott Sully, you mentioned the issues at parks. Let me show you what residents are talking about. We're here at A.L. Davis Park. You have dirty socks, plastic bottles, bag. You saw that video as the water was shooting out of the ground. This is what it looks like right now. Sewerage and waterboard crews are here. As you can see, there was a sinkhole that street caved in, so they've been working now. They turned off water in the area.
This is the WDSU Hot Seat. I'm Juliana Mazza. I'm reading a potential 80% cut to that program. How do you explain, I mean, the impact that could have on children here in the state?
It's enormous.
Lots of evidence that was presented in this case, and one of the issues seemed to be who was the aggressor. Three dead, seven wounded, an employee still locked inside of a building after shots were fired in New Orleans. Right now, a reward for information is being offered as police try to figure out who did this and why. We are following breaking news. Not one, but two utility poles have fallen across Clearview Parkway. For the past 8 days, coaches, executives, and players have been paying tribute to Tom Benson. One of those players is Saints punter Thomas Morstead. He talked with me one-on-one about the impact Benson had on the team and how he personally helped to change Morstead's life. The Saints are on fire. They're now 10-1 this season and, knock on wood, have eyes on the Super Bowl. Well, let's go to like the top five approved gifts from the internet. We know that can be super reliable. Parents are always like, oh, we don't want anything. And you know you have to get them something.
Yeah.
So it's like you don't get any direction there.
Oh, guys, it is just so beautiful down here and I want to show you why. There's so many lights. We have some fake snow that is falling down. How you feeling?
Feeling like a turkey on Thanksgiving, baby.
I guess that's a good thing, so we'll take it. There are tens of thousands of people here on Bourbon Street. It is just electric. This is my first Mardi Gras. I've seen Bourbon Street before, but I have never seen it like this. And I'll have a full wrap-up of all the fun tonight on WDSU News at 10. Back to you guys. I got a chance to put it to the test. I wonder if I can fit my whole body through. Do people like go head first? They do. Okay. All right. Queen of Soul who brought and still brings the love. And the people of New Orleans spreading that love with everyone, even a first time second liner. I wanted to be here for Sam's big day.
Juliana is an angel, Sam. Appreciate you so much.